Thank you, Carl. The numbers are staggering. Just 670,000 Australians have been vaccinated, falling well short of the Prime Minister's original target of 4 million people by today. And get this, 2.4 million doses are just sitting there, unused on the shelf. We're joined now by Dr. Mukesh Harkawal from Melbourne. What's going so badly wrong? Why aren't they getting out there?
I think what we're seeing is ramping up happening as the vaccines become more available. There's been an early supply shortage at the beginning as we had blockages from supplies from Europe, and of course the Pfizer vaccine didn't come in the quantities that we were expecting. In our state, the state government set up these vaccine hubs for in hospitals for health professionals and quarantine workers, and that's really going a treat. They're really getting through them quite quickly. And I think the new multi sites at the exhibition centre and the exhibition buildings will be a great addition to what we're doing. I think the problem is people not knowing that they're available and who they're available for. And I think the messaging needs to be quite clear so we can actually start using them. We've got to get as many people vaccinated as quickly as possible. And this methodology will work very well. And of course, we've just seen general practice coming online. We started Monday last week. And of course, we're still doing other things as well, like business as usual. So we can't shut down normal general practice to just do vaccinations. So we're trying to weave around what's available and to get as many people done as we can and ramp up. We're certainly ramping up over Easter. We'll be doing vaccinations on Saturday of Easter and Easter Monday.
It has to get more, it has to get faster, doesn't it? Because it's not so much the ones that we didn't receive in the country, but it's the ones that are on the shelf that aren't getting delivered. Can we do better?
Look, I think that there's been a lot of sharpening of the way the delivery chain is working. I know for a fact that people had problems at the beginning of last week, but that's now been sorted. I think the department federally, believe it or not, has actually been listening and made things work better. The delivery companies are working well. The health department has been smashed in trying to get this all done federally and every state. And I think that the comments earlier heard is they've got to work better and work together. And I know Carl says it can't be done, but it should be done. This isn't winners and losers. Everybody's got to be a winner here. Every state, every national government, every local government, but actually every Australian. This is about Australia, not about party politics.
Yeah, it would be good if everybody could get together and work out how we could make it faster. It just doesn't seem to be happening. Now, we've seen this morning in Melbourne a huge vaccination centre running at one-tenth of their capacity. What's happening there? That's a bit shocking.
Yeah, look, I think there's two parts to it. One is they've been set up fairly recently, so the word isn't out there yet, and also who they're available to. What's happened is we've got large numbers of frontline workers that didn't get in into 1A who are now available to get vaccinated, and many other employment groups. And then, of course, we've got the people who are coming through general practice, which is the people who are 55 and over who are Aboriginal Torres Strait Islander, 70 plus for everybody else, those with chronic diseases, and a bunch of other health and employment groups. So we've got to get them through general practice. The problem, of course, is the capacity is building up. Originally, out of 8,600 general practices, 1,000 started. It's going to go up to 4,600. But, you know, we can actually get the others involved as well. And with these multi-hubs, you can actually get lots of people participating, retired doctors and nurses and people who've immunised, and also people who are part-timers or want to come back and provide a bit more service. So we need to work smartly. We need to get our people on deck, and we need to make sure we get the facilities able to cope with them, with the numbers coming through. Because it's not just stopping at 1A, 1B. This has got to go through the whole of the Australian population. We can't hang around. And I absolutely agree that whatever's out there should be out of the fridges and into people's arms. Every arm, any vaccine.
OK, Dr. Harkawal, thank you very much. Throughout the pandemic, the New South Wales and federal governments have been a united force until now. The Premier lashing out at the Commonwealth for presenting untrue facts over the vaccine doses handed out to her state. And the Premier, Gladys Berejiklian, joins us now from Sydney. Premier, untrue facts, is that a polite way of saying lies?
Put it this way. The New South Wales government is really, really keen to help the federal government roll out the vaccine. And that's what the people of New South Wales and the people of Australia want to know. If we don't help the Commonwealth, they will not be able to meet their own deadlines for rolling out the vaccine. As a state, New South Wales has been asked to do 300,000 vaccines. We've done 100,000 already. We're a third of the way through. And when we finish the 300,000 we've been asked to do, because there's around 6 million people in New South Wales that need to get vaccinated, we're saying to the Commonwealth, let us help you. We can do tens of thousands of vaccines a week. Let us help you through the GP network you have, because we know the GPs are going to be doing their part. But that won't be able to meet the demand of getting 6 million people done in New South Wales by the end of October. It's just not manageable. And we're saying to the Commonwealth, let us help you, which they haven't agreed to. We've got 100 hubs set up ready to go around New South Wales. They haven't agreed to that. And secondly, we were rolled up yesterday as a state government because we've been getting out the doses as soon as we can. We have online booking systems. Our frontline staff have been doing an amazing job and making sure it's safe and everybody comes through. But when you have doses dumped on your doorstep, which is fine, if they give us more doses than we expect, we're happy with that. But you can't put out figures the next day saying you haven't put out those doses. For example, last week we were supposed to get around 13,000. We got 45,000, which is great. But you can't put out information the next day that says, oh, you haven't put the doses out. It takes good planning, it takes getting the staff in those hubs, and away we go. We have our systems in place. I think we're the only state that has an online kind of no paper booking system. And we just want to help get this vaccine out because it will mean less restrictions. It'll mean you can travel overseas. I don't want Australia to fall behind the world. And I certainly want New South Wales to keep pushing the Commonwealth to hurry up and get these vaccines out.
Yeah, Premier, you found yourself in an unlikely but slightly terrifying alliance with Anastasia Palaszczuk yesterday. If I was the Prime Minister, I would be nervous about that. Have you heard from the federal government since then?
Not officially, but I'm looking forward to that today. And can I stress, it wasn't the Prime Minister that made those comments or put that information out, it was some ministers. And I say to those ministers, the New South Wales government has done nothing but support you during this process. We've always worked with you. We've been one team for the benefit of the community. Let's continue that. Don't denigrate the work we've done. Don't denigrate the frontline staff who are working night and day to get those vaccines out, and let us help you. And pretty simple message, and I hope they're listening.
All right, let's have a look at the very far north of your state and Byron Bay, the Northern Rivers there. You had someone testing positive there yesterday. How worried are you? You're in the know. What can we expect today?
Oh, look, I'm not overly concerned because I think the people of that region, as have the people of the state, really taken the health advice on board. And whilst I know businesses might be disappointed, please know that they can still open. They've just got to be subject to the 4 square metre rule, which we recently had for all of New South Wales. So the good news is everything is still open. We're just asking people to take those extra precautions. And to be fair, that part of New South Wales to date has done really well because the other states wouldn't let us go on holiday. A lot of people had been holidaying in the Northern Rivers, the northern part, north coast, north to mid coast of New South Wales. So whilst I know Easter is always a good time for businesses to do well, touch wood, they have had a consistent kind of patronage in the last few months. And whilst they'll still be open, they'll still have people in them, we're just asking people to respect the 4 square metre rule just until the end of Easter and make sure they're sitting down when they're having lunch or dinner or another
right.
event. And
Can I ask you a question? It affects Carl and I, but I think it would affect a lot of people too. Can people from your state travel into Queensland and be secure that they will be allowed to come back after Easter? And can people from the Northern Rivers leave that region now, or are you advising them to stay home?
Yeah, look, as far as New South Wales is concerned, we always have open borders. So our citizens should never feel they can't come back home. The only thing we ask is if you've come back from an area which has had a lot of cases, so we said to everybody, if you've just come back from Brisbane since the 20th of March, if Brisbane's in a 3-day lockdown, well, then you personally have to stay in your home for 3 days and respect that lockdown. But aside from that, that is the beauty of, well, I shouldn't use that word because it's a pandemic, but that is why New South Wales has been really keen to keep our borders open so that if our citizens do go elsewhere into other states, they're always welcome back into their state. They don't have to do that 14-day quarantine. quarantine. We think that's silly, and we would urge other states to keep their borders open as well. In terms of travelling, you're allowed to go anywhere as far as New South Wales citizens are concerned, but obviously if Brisbane remains in lockdown, we don't recommend that. But the Queensland Premier, I understand, in a few hours, 10 o'clock our time, 9 o'clock her time, will be making an announcement about Brisbane. She may very well lift the lockdown, and if that's the case, that would mean people should feel more comfortable in travelling, but we have to wait for the health advice. And more importantly, we just say to families, as I did a few days ago, because it's still a bit of a volatile situation, you can go anywhere else in Queensland, but just assess the risk. Right. You might need to stay in your hotel room if there's suddenly a lockdown or whatever else. And so we just say to people, a few days ago, our message was a bit stronger to suggest revise your plans, don't go there at all. But the situation will depend on what the Queensland government tells us today about their cases and how well they're controlling it.
OK, Premier, thank you. We were half hoping you would say leave Carl in Queensland.
Oh, wow.
thank you very much. Thanks for coming on the show. OK.
I cut her audio.
Yeah.